It is I, everyone's favorite jack of all trades with foul mouth, Commodore Urban. And today we are going to be continuing with reading Angels of the Atlantic, my fan fiction that I wrote about ship spirits. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump into chapter 10. Chapter 10, Britannic, the patroness of the Mediterranean. A couple of weeks passed, and it was time to set off to Greece to explore the wreck of the Britannic, to see if I could find the object that her spirit was trapped in. Ugh, today is the day. Today is the day. I'm heading out to Greece. Got dressed and walked down the stairs to the living room. I went by my lazy chair and grabbed a large roll of blue paper, and I was about to walk out the door when I heard two voices behind me. Glenn? I turned around and saw Titanic and Olympic. Yes, Titanic? What is it?
I thought you said that I could come along and meet my sister.
I did a facepalm just now. Oh, God, I forgot all about it. I'm so sorry, Titanic.
The Olympic came over. You heading off to Greece?
Yes, I'm heading off to Greece to retrieve Britannic, if I could find her at her watery grave. You gonna come?
You said I could come, so yes, I want to be there when you bring our sister up from her watery tomb.
Cleared my throat. Well, I'm going with my friend Alan, and he doesn't really know much about you guys, so...
Yeah, I understand.
The Olympic magically went back into the piece of superstructure, and the Titanic went into the section of hull plating, and both glowed and stopped. I picked them up, and I headed out the door. Once I headed to the docks, Alan was waiting there with a small vessel and six other guys aboard. Glenn, this is the crew. Here's Chris, Greg, George, Leonard, Matt, and Paul. They're going to be helping us get to the Britannic and helping us photograph the wreck as well.
Wow, you do know how to assemble a good crew, I said, amazed.
Well, Glenn, you know me. I'm good at what I do. Let's set sail for Britannic. So I got on board in the research vessel and went on our way. Several days later, we were in the Kia Channel off the coast of Greece, and we were over the wreck of the HMHS Britannic.
Glenn, are you ready to see Britannic?
Alan yelled out.
Yeah, sure. I'm ready to see the patroness. I got my scuba gear on, and we both dove off to the ship. We dove down a long, long route, and a few minutes later I saw a massive object before me. It was Britannic. In a muffled voice, I was like,
wow, Britannic is large.
Yes, it is,
Jake, Alan said.
Now let's go in and take a look around.
I looked around and got to the area where the bridge once was, and I started to take a peek around here and there, and then I saw something glowing. It was on the floor of the ocean, right nearby the bridge wing cab that was crushed on the seafloor. And I went for it. It was a piece of what appeared to be an upper structure of plate. It had a weird faint gold glow to it.
Alan, I found something. Take a look. Wow, that's cool, Clint. Grab it. Well, I'm going on to get it. Alright, I'm going to go check out the tail. Alright, Alan.
I reached for the piece of steel and I grabbed it.
Got it.
Once I got it, I put it into a mesh bag I had on my side and swam to the tear in the fork part of the hull with Alan. Then me and Alan examined it for any evidence of a smoking gun that had caused the Britannic to sink to her doom. But we did find the four funnels on the debris field, which were massive. Then we had to head back up to the surface. Once we decompressed and was back on the boat, four other guys dove in. "Wow, I can't believe how big she is," I exclaimed. "I know, and it still gets my breath every time I see her," said Alan as he looked around. "The Britannic is definitely one of those wonders." "Wow, that was amazing. Thank you for inviting me to come and do this with you, Alan." "You're welcome, Glenn. But before we do leave, I thought me and you might make a few more dives in the next few days to show you some of the other amazing things about the Britannic." "Sounds great to me, Alan." "All right. What I'll have to do is wait a few hours and then we can head off for another dive. How's that sound?"
"Sounds like fun, Alan."
"I know it is, because I'm a captain of fun." 45 minutes later, the four divers came back, and me and Alan went down again. In the next several days, we made a few more dives. He showed me all the incredible things about the Britannic. And then when we hit the surface for the last time, we got on board the vessel and it pulled anchor and we sailed back to England. Okay, sailed back on board to England. I had my own cabin on the research vessel. I was looking at the piece of the Britannic's structural plate that I picked up off the bottom of the Kia channel. I was examining it and it had a faint glow to it. Then I called out the Titanic and Olympic. "Hey ladies, I got something for you." Then they came out of the pieces of metal that was once part of themselves that I brought along.
"Yes, Glenn, what is it?" Titanic asked in excitement.
"Yeah, Glenn, what is it?" Olympic looked as she put her arm on my shoulder, figuring out what I was talking about. I showed him the piece of metal that I salvaged from the Britannic.
"What is it, Glenn?" Titanic asked eagerly.
"Someone you wanted to meet for a long time." Then I gave the steel a good rub, and I set it down on the ground and it started glowing. And it shook and it spewed gold dust into the air of the cabin until it went round and round and round until all the gold dust blew out into a cloud and disappeared. What was left was a young woman, probably between 17 and 19 years of age. She was in a nurse's outfit, pure white dress with a red cross at her midsection and a green stripe a little lower down, and yellow dots allowing main dress part and a red stripe at the bottom. Her hair was a yellowish tan blonde, same as her two sisters, and it was done up in a bun. She had a nurse's hat with a red cross in the center, but the thing that caught my attention was her necklace. It read RMS Britannic in white star line with diamonds encrusted into it with a company flag, just like her sister's. But she also had another necklace. It was a red dog tag which read in white letters G618. I approached her and I said very calmly, "Hello there, miss. My name is Glenn Barker. I am an ocean liner historian. Would you be the HMHS Britannic?" She looked at me very puzzled.
"Yes."
A very polite Irish voice came.
"Yes, my name is Britannic. It is nice to meet you, Mr. Barker.
You can call me Glenn. But I wanted to introduce you to someone, to some folks, Britannic. If you remember, these are your sisters, Olympic, and the sister you never got to know, Titanic." Britannic walks up to Olympic.
"Olympic? Is that you?"
"Yes, Brit, it is me.
Oh, I missed you so much.
So have I, Britt. So have I.
I wanted you to meet your other sister, Titanic. Britannic walks up to Titanic. Titanic looks at Britannic. Britannic does the same. So you are my famous sister? Britannic asks Titanic. Are you my baby sis? Titanic asks. The Olympic comes over. Britannic, this is your older sister, Titanic. And yes, Titanic, this is your baby sister.
So you are my older sister, are you? Britannic asks.
Yes, I am, Titanic said. I finally get to meet you, finally. I was told I would never get to because, well, you sank on your maiden voyage, Britannic said as she hugged Titanic.
I did, and I never knew I had a baby sister until now. Now I do, and I'm proud to call you my family, you and Olympic both. We even look somewhat the same, but I'm proud to call you my sister.
Then Olympic joins in. I finally am glad to have both of my sisters with me at last.
Glenn, thank you so much for keeping your promise, Titanic said.
I blushed. Oh, it was nothing at all. I was glad to help you.
Then they all three Olympic class sisters chatted on to the night.
I had accomplished a promise to Titanic, and I'm happy to bring them all back together as one big happy family. But what will happen next? I do wonder.
Thank you for listening, and until next time, this is Commodore Urban saying, have smooth seas and clear skies, happy sailing with you. God bless you, stay safe, stay healthy, stay awesome, and be yourself. Cheers.